Let's see how to start this stream. This is a kind of atypical stream because I am not working with Godot. Instead, I am working in Godot, on Godot itself. The idea is the following. Many people has complained that the tileset editor is so difficult to use. Because of this, the idea is to make it easier for users to edit tilesets. Open editor. Now, there are many ways to do this, but I think that the easier way to do this will be imitate the way the tilet map editor works for tilesets. That's why I am downloading it right now to give it a look at how it works. Is someone around? I'll search some music to use as background. I don't have my music over here. Can't remember. I had a link for listening music on the web. Well, whatever. The idea in here is to remake the tileset editor to make it more like tilet map editor. So let's download it. Before starting to work, I think we could make a mock-up of how is it going to look like, how it's going to work like. Yeah, whatever, what is the download button? Here. For Mac, for Linux. Suppose is this one. I have no idea if they have been implemented yet. Well, with this instance, we could start making a mock-up of how this is going to turn. So let's start with a new scene. Looks like it crashed. Well, whatever. I am not using the latest version for this. Let's use a simple one. I'm just making a mock-up of how this is going to look when it finished. When it is finished. Custom color, custom size, size flats, vertical expand. Yeah, whatever. Offset. And edit. Size flags, horizontal expand. Cutout is awesome for some stuff like this, especially everything related to UI is awesome. Let's create some margin just because of reasons. Here we go. The idea is an editor like Tilets. Let's try to install it. Looks like it is ripping. I just have to copy and paste this. Desktop, create folder, pilot, extract, show files, user, team, pilot. All right, new map. Desktop, create the map, new patterns, I need a file as an example, computer, media, documents. Something like this. Yeah, this one is gonna work. Tilet makes an auto slicing and then allow to set up stuff like terrains and stuff like that. You can create a terrain. And then edit the terrain data over here. Yeah. Problem is that these terrains are 2x2 tile sets and this tile set is 3x3, so it's not gonna work with this one. Maybe we should change the soul for something else. Well, whatever. The point is to have something more like this, where you can display the texture and work over the texture instead of just adding a tile one by one. Let's see, everything looks blurry, the resolution is quite bad. Some is good, fine, that's good to know. Well, I am not sure how to improve the resolution. I can improve the bitrate maybe. But no, I prefer it to be blurry and not erratic and stop constantly like it used to be, because I used to have 90% of lost frames. So I think this is good enough, because we are mostly working with text only. Alright, going back to our mockup. So I think what we should start doing is get something like this to have our texture listed in here and make our tiles passing on our texture instead of the opposite. So first of all, what I am going to do is file the current tileset editor. Comment it to start over with it. We have some stuff included. Tileset editor helper, edit mode, collision, occlusion. Okay, let's start commenting this. Starting over here. I think we can leave this. Over here. Def 0. This is going to comment everything up into here. Now, giving this instruction to the preprocessor will make to ignore all of this. That way I can start adding new code little by little without being disturbed by the old code. Tileset editor helper. I want to remember what was this for. Ah, right. This was to allow this. Let me show you. Tile set. This button allows you to create a new resource. Being used or not, I just created a new tile set and I am currently editing it. The tile set editor helper is an object used only on edition mode that has the properties displayed in here, in this property editor. It was used to edit the layout and the tile size of the auto tiles. We will most probably not need it anymore, so let's comment it completely. Let's see, there is something over here. I'm not sure, it isn't the bitrate. Maybe it's YouTube scaling down the image to keep the stream up. But yeah, just keep going, better up stream, pixelated and high quality image stream with 8 million slide, like I did once. First time here, I'm shutting up with a lot of questions. Well, make sure to make all the questions you want. Right now we're modifying the engine itself, so I will shortly explain you how this works from behind the scenes. So this class is the entrance point for the all the plugins in the editor of Godot. If you look over here, editor node.cpp, it has a function somewhere where it registers all the editors. Let's see, tileset editor. Yeah, this is something else. Here, add editor plugin, tileset editor plugin. This long list of stuff are sub editors added to the final editor. All these editors are inheriting the editor plugin class. The editor plugin class has basic functions to allow being registered and shown and hidden when stuff is being edited. Let's take an example. Right now I am editing the tile set. If I go somewhere over here, right now the current object is line edit. This allows to the control editor plugin be displayed in here, and also allows the tileset editor to realize they don't edit the line edit, and then it hides itself. This happens this way. Da, da, da. If you, as you can see, it has very little functions and variables. It has a virtual function that returns the name of the editor. It has a virtual function that it says if it has or doesn't have a main screen, which in this case is not. To make it clear, a main screen is this one: 2D, 3D, script, setlib. This is it. These are the main screens. A virtual function called edit. I will explain what it does later. A virtual function that make if it handles, and a virtual function that tells the editor to make visible or not. That's all you need to make a plugin in Godot. When something is selected like this, tileset, it will first make a function tile to this virtual function handles. Then you have to this function has to return true or false depending on if this object can be handled or not. In this case, it will return true only if the object is of tile set. This will make it to return true. Now, after that, the editor says, well, if the plugin handles the object, then it will make a call to make visible and pass an argument visible as true because it handled it. On the other hand, if it doesn't handle the object, it will call make visible with a false value. This works for this part of the screen and this button over here are part of the editor. When I select an object like this one that is not handled by the plugin, they have to be hidden. So this code is gonna be called with visible as false. When visible is false, this is gonna be run. Tileset editor, tileset menu, tileset editor, side panel, tileset editor, bottom panel. All these controls that are part of the editor plugin are gonna hide, and that's what happens when you click something that is not a tileset, like now. See, everything what is hidden now. On the other hand, when you select something that is handled by the editor, be visible is gonna be true. And so, and because of this, all this stuff that are controls, control nodes are gonna be displayed and allow you to edit the object. After this happens, if the object can be handled, it will then call edit object. At this point, what you have to do is initialize your editor to allow editing this object. And that's all you need to know to add an editor plugin to Godot. Doing this in GDScript is basically the same. You have to make a script that extends editor plugin, override all those functions, and make everything works with the tool keyboard on top of the script. I was thinking in making something completely different for the tileset because most of people doesn't understand how to edit it. Because of this, I wanted to be more explicit when editing a tileset. Instead of having this control over here and this hidden over here, I wanted to use the entire screen to edit the tileset. It's not so nice, it's not so Godot-like, but I think it's gonna be easier for everyone to use. So, let's give it a look. Let's see, we have some comments over here. I can't read anything. Low resolution, happy. I'm great fan of yours. This resolution a bit, I don't know how. Hey, Clonoa, thanks a lot, really appreciate the support. Using Qt Creator, yes, that's the best idea in the world. Akus Puddy, he's using a good rest. YouTube is crashing quality though. Waiting for the camera shake, blah 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 blah. Well, I didn't even see this button dock. Really? This button allows to edit the auto tiles. Let's see. Oh, run without deployment. Yeah, whatever. Right now I am running Last Master. Here. This is the project I was using to test tilesets, auto-tiling, while I was working on it. Here you can select the tileset and open the editor in here. And here, when you open the editor, a tileset button will appear in, down here. This tile in here is an auto tile. This allows you to edit all this information about the tile. That way you can, for example, for this one, edit the collision of the object. So, this one is not set as an auto tile. You will need to come in here, search for it, tile mode, auto tile. That allows you to use it as an auto tile. After that, you use these properties to set the mode and to set the size of the tile set, and then you can edit everything in here. And yes, that's exactly why we want to change it to be more friendly to people, because there are so many steps to be that need to be done to allow you to edit it. Right now, the next step will be changing the bitmask, something like this. You paint whatever is part of your dial. Then you have to set up collision. Let's say you come to the collision, click the create collision, activate the snap, for example, make a 16 by 16 grid, and then you can use the mouse to create the collision shape like this. And there you go, you have to create one collision per tile or more. You can make as many collisions as you need. One for this, and that's how it's done. Once you have set up all the collisions, you can, for example, set the occlusion. Let's say this part of the level, create a occlusion polygon, and this part of the level is gonna make a shadow. In fact, I am not sure if this is already the case for this, because I'm not sure what's the state of this project, because I haven't touched it in a long time. Yeah, I was playing with this for trying the optional typing, which now I revert, so this is not gonna work as is. Yeah, I changed the sprite of the light, or not. The character is wrong. Ah, the light is turned off. That's better. Have no idea of how much I messed this texture over here. Don't remember why or how this is repeat. But that's not the point. The point is you can set up occlusion on the map and you can edit this map, have the walls draw by its own and the shadow will appear on while you need it, and it works all out of the box. Well, any question over here? Cute hat? Yeah, I'm pretty sure I never tweaked it with the dog there. It is on master or it is on 3.0.x. Yep, it is already on Godot 3. You can do this since a long time ago when I made the auto tiles work. Try to develop our tools and backend per game. If you focus too much on this, you will be more on the engine development than the actual game development. Yeah, that's kind of what I do. I like a friend told me develop the games, not the technology. Well, that's actually depends on what you want or what you like. I like making tools and I like Godot, so I make Godot whenever I can. When you face something while developing the game that you can that you think must be improved, then you dig into tool development. Yes, the little difference is that if you make this in JavaScript, in CDScript, and make it for your game, you can make it an add-on, you can share it, whatever, but making it in C++ and contribute it to the engine will make it available to everyone automatically. And I think this is something that deserves to be shared to everyone, because it is right now too difficult to make auto tiles. So, will this the need to make tileset TSCN will be solved? Yes, the idea is not to need doing that anymore. It won't be removed, but that wouldn't be needed. But that's what I want, make the tools. I'm just in university, so I don't know how to do anything yet. I don't think being or not in a university makes any difference at all. So let's say instead of converting to tileset.tres, you should create a tileset directly. You can already do that. You can press here, search tileset, over here use this menu, add item. Right now you have a zero tile. You can come here, search for a texture for it. You can set an offset, you can load a normal, you can give it a name. You can modulate it, you can set a region for it. Let's say 32 by 32 or 64 by 64. Add an occlusion polygon, add a navigation polygon, oops, add a collision shape. Let's, for example, you can add a rectangle, edit the rectangle, set extents to 32 by 32 to make it occupy the entire tile. This was already possible since Godot 1, but it is too troublesome to be done this way, so that's why some stuff has been created to allow editing this. Let's see. Yes. So, what's the point on this? Great footnote. Haven't seen this before. Nice. Well, back to the works. This is the idea I have in mind. Let's see what you think about it. My idea is to have a list of textures in here. Every texture can have several tile sets. In here we are going to have a toolbar. And a working area. Let's say it expands vertically, and maybe we're going to change the color of this custom styles panel, new style box flat. Yeah, that's enough just to make it clear. The idea is to have something like this where you can set the texture in here. And then one of these buttons will be select tile, the other one will be add single tile, next one will be add auto tile, next button will be add palette tile. This is something new that I am wanting to add, and then will come a separator in here. Separator like this, and then comes the option for the tile that is being selected right now. So you could add a new tile, and when you add it, it is gonna be selected automatically, or you can select any tile and use these buttons to edit its properties the same way that it is done right now in here, using this option, collision, occlusion, navigation, bit mask, whatever. So let's see if we have something new. But it is not as visual as making through a scene and converting it, right? Oh, okay. Yeah. Just to make it clear, besides that workflow, you could. Let's see if I have a tileset scene like this one. See, this scene has the tiles added one by one. You could create the tileset, and instead of using the menu over here on the scene, and create the scene over here using convert to tileset, you could take it from here, tileset, and use this button that says merge from scene. This is kind of troublesome. Let's wait a little. Where is the editor configuration? Da-da-da-da-da. Language English. So I have to close it up. Don't save. I want to save this one. Let's ruin it again. And it should be on English now. Yeah, it's on English now. So, as I was saying, you can either use this button over here and convert to tileset, or you can create a tileset and use this menu over here to merge the from the scene. This one, create from the scene, will delete all the tiles and create the tiles again using this scene over here. So, what was the point? This scene, this a scene I made before I decided to do the auto-tiles the way that I did, because I was thinking in my mind how to make collision works in different ways depending on what the auto-tile creates. So I realized that this makes no sense at all and forgot completely about the idea and moved it to another way. That way happened to be this editor that I wanted it to be as much possible similar to the tiled editor. Here you can edit a terrain, add a terrain. With the terrain selected, you could edit the tile mask, the bit mask. But the problem with this is that it doesn't, or better said, what is not nice about tile that is nicer in cutout is the tile only allows 2x2 bit mask, and I did in a way where you can have both 2x2 or 3x3 bit mask. Well, back to the work. Right now I want to make something that looks like this, at least for now. So we are going to have this toolbar over here and this secondary toolbar that will work for the selected item. That will be the same one that we have over here already: collision, occlusion, navigation, bitmask, priority and icon. Under that we have a second toolbar that depends on what do you have selected over here. Collision have these tools, occlusion have these tools, whatever. And we still have to think how to sort this stuff around, but I think we can make it work. So let's start by the basics. Let's create this panel and add this list, and then think what should we do next. We have an split as child of the tileset. This container has this line that is meant for searching for textures. Maybe I won't add it in the first place. The list itself, and then we could, for example, add something like this. Something like this that will have buttons to add texture and remove texture. Yeah, something like this would do. Let's start with this part. Something like that looks exactly like this part over here. A panel, and a split container, and a vertical container with these controls inside. But not this one in first place. I don't know if we are going to need it anyway. But let's see what happens. So you prototype in Godot and then port it to C++. Well, this one it's easier to think how to nest controls because I can see them visually. I can see which flags have enabled each control. For example, this container have none, but this panel over here has the expand selected, this tileset editor is set to full rect, the split is set to full rect. It's easier to find out how to place stuff and how to nest the tiles to make it. Let's save the scene. To make it as responsive as possible, because if you can see, I can play it. And I can resize this window. This button. I can resize this window, and this is completely responsive. I can resize over here, use this handle over here, and everything just works. Press the buttons, use this area. I think you'll get the point. But let's move to the real work already. So this one is fine. This function, I'm going to comment this part because for now we are going to have a single editor, so we don't. And I am going to mix everything inside of it, so we shouldn't need all of this. Instead, I have to add this editor in a different way. So, let me explain how should I add this panel to the editor, because right now Godot gives us easy ways to add new docs, easy ways to add new principal or main views, gives us ways to add bottom panels. But what I want to do to make it easier for the people to use the space on the screen is use this entire rectangle. I can do this in two ways actually. I could choose make a dialogue like this one, making a dialogue and put everything on a dialogue, or I can choose place a panel in here and work over the current scene like the theme editor used it to be. I am not sure what's the best solution, but I am start using the panel for a very simple reason. If I use a dialogue like this one, I can't use the inspector in here to work. I can set properties, I can't do stuff like changing current tiles properties or stuff like that. That's because I want to try putting a panel in here first and see what happens. Now, for this, I am going to explain you how the editor works. The editor is, as you probably know, just a Godot game. It has nodes, control nodes like this nested, that at this menu, that is docs, that is tabs over here, that the scene over here. Everything works just the same. So, how is the scene rendered in here? Well, imagine this is a Vbox container just like this, where you have the tabs, then the toolbar, and then the scene in here. The scene is actually just a control. The control fits the entire editor place, and then it just has a viewport inside. This viewport has a render target. I think it has a render target enabled, and then choose the nodes of this scene are added to this viewport, and this viewport is rendered in this control. That's actually everything that happens in here. So this control is child of another control. Let's make it like this. Suppose this is like this. This is the editor. This is the scene control. This is a viewport. And this is the edited scene root. So what I want to do is exactly this. Put it over and show and hide it. That's what I want to do. So I have to find a way to get this scene control to add my panel as its sibling. Any question now? Hey, my name's Vigo, gotta go back to work now, can't edit video and listen to stream for 30 minutes, so good luck with your work. Okay, have good luck you too. So, any question up until now? Let's give it a try. So, what parts of this can be at control to container, editor menu, tileset editor? Right now, tileset editor has this menu in here. I am not sure if we should keep it because we are not going to use this add item and remove item anymore, but this create from scene and merge from scene could be useful, but we can always put them in here. And this will make this menu no longer useful because we already have that options in here. We could even have something like this. It says add is going to be a plus, remove is going to be an X, and then choose these two buttons in here. And probably a control in the middle to work as a separator, where I can say size flags, expand horizontally, and that will make that will force these buttons to be aligned to the left, to the right. So that should work. I think I'm going to start with this. So this menu is going to go away anyways. So let's give it a try. Set anchor preset, preset top width. That's not the one I want. Preset width. I think this is the one I want to use. Preset mode. New size. In fact, I don't need this one for this. And I need to add this to a container. For now, let's add it to the bottom. Container canvas editor bottom tileset editor. Right, let's just try it like this and let's see what happens with tileset editor. Let's comment all of this. For what's commenting here? There it goes. Let's comment this. Tileset editor edit, show texture editor version edit. We will probably not use this anymore because we are going to make a sub editor for this. I'm going to comment it for now. Yeah, that works. Any question? Nope. So let's start with the tileset editor itself. Tileset editor, editor node, tool button, tileset editor version, button. I want to use this for now, and I think this is complete for now. So let's start with the tileset editor. Let's see what happens in here. It's going to inherit a panel instead of a control. Friend class of the editor plugin shouldn't be friend of the text, the texture region editor. Edit mode, collision, occlusion, navigation, bitmap icon. We are going to keep this. Tune bitmask, shape, mask. What was this toolbar for? Ah, now I remember. Yeah. What a terrible name for a toolbar. I am most probably don't use this enum anymore. Tileset tools. This enum has the list to all the controls in this toolbar in here and this toolbar in here. No, actually all the buttons in this toolbar in here. This is how it worked. The first enum, this one is the edit mode. The edit mode is the upper toolbar. Now, depending on what you selected, different options should be displayed down here. And this is divided by three toolbars. This is what is called the Tumi toolbar, because it's displayed almost always. This is the it's hard to whatever. Every of these toolbars separated by these separators are individual controls that are inside a HBOT separator like this one with the buttons inside of it. So that was the reason to exist in the first place, because instead of making every button visible and invisible depending on the mode and the situation, I made the entire toolbar or the entire Xbox container visible or invisible. So we can forget about it for now, because we're going to start with the texture, and we can start working on this. Okay. What do we need to have a reference at, and what do we don't need a reference to? I think we don't need a reference to this, or to this, or to this. We're going to need the item list. We are not adding this for now. And we are going to need reference for these buttons over here. So we're going to add an enum for those buttons. Let's call it texture to buttons. Let's say to texture add or to tileset add texture to, oops, to tileset remove texture tool tileset create from scene to tileset merge scene. Let's delete this. I don't think this is gonna work. Tool tileset max. Let's forget this. Now, the third thing we will have are the tool buttons. This is gonna have tool tileset max as the size of the array. So inside this array of 4 items, because here you have 0, 1, 2, 3 and 4, we're going to have all 4 buttons for these options. So it's easier to access them. That's exactly why this works. That's what this is for. This is to access to all those buttons without needing to have one single variable for every of these. So before I forget, we're going to need a list, or was it called item list, texture list, and I think we can start over with the constructor. Should be public. I'm going to cut this and paste it over here. And let's start changing stuff. I'm going to comment it this for now. With that library file, I have no idea what this does. I'm going to give it a look because it puts in, but it looks like this is gonna work for the merge button. Interesting. This is obviously useful for the merge button. And the constructor and destructor. Helper, delete helper. Commenting this for now because I have no idea if we are going to use it anyways. Alright. We are not going to use this anymore. And let's start with we are going to use choose interface utilities. Open editor. Get some add control to menu panel. Blah blah blah. Okay. I just wanted to keep this function local. So let's say. This is a split container. I think it's actually an horizontal split. Or was it vertical? Horizontal. This is a pointer. The child, let's just call it split. Now let's add the left container. This is a VBox container. This should be an H split container. Dot agile left container. I got this left container dot set size flex vertical flex. How is this flag call? Oh. Whatever looks like I don't need it anyways. Let's just add the item list. Container a child texture list. Xbox container tile set toolbar container equals menu Xbox container. This one is this toolbar, and we have to start adding the buttons to this one. So first let's add it to the left container, and why I have two brackets over here. And now we can start creating the buttons for this toolbar. Whatever. So how did we call it? Tileset to toolbar buttons. This one is add texture equals menu tool button. Set text. We are going to do this just for now to be able to recognize them, and let's connect these buttons to a new function that we have to create later. We can make this in different ways. See, there are no more comments. Let's increase a little the size for the people who can read it better. And let's copy it a drive. I'm not connecting the signals for now. The toolbar container dot add child there's a button container, and we're going to make this 4 times for all different buttons. Let's say remove, create scene, and merge scene. Going to create the right container Vertical box container. Write container equals name new. Box container. And split a child write container. That's gonna work. Hope. Be right back, I'm going for a drink. Right, I am back. Let me know if there is still someone around. So let's see what should we do now. Let's create a function to catch these buttons, just to have it connected. Let's create a function like this. Tileset toolbar button press. That will work. Handle press. I need a way to whatever. I am a little confused. Let's just go on. Middle of this, let's see. Okay. Middle of this, I need the separator control. Size, expand field, this one, and just a bit to the toolbar. And that's gonna work. Right now we have all of this in the scene, and this one like this. So I don't think we can test it anyways. Let's try to connect the sync now. Connect signal name. What happened? First, next, which object? This next, what's the method? Let's search it. We just created it. Pins, this is a vector of variance with with extra arguments for this function call. So let's say the new vector variant args dot pushback something like this. Let's just say this should work. So something like this will work for everything. We should have to change this one. Change this. Okay, now it's connect, but this function can't be referenced by name, just because to be referenced by name it has to be registered first, and to be registered it needs to be used on the method bin methods in here. So as you can see, there are a lot of functions that are binned, and we have to bind this one too. Place database bind method. We have to search for the method which is created, which is on here. Oops. And give it a pointer of the to the function it is gonna go. Tileset editor, and this one. Now this is complete. A lot of these functions are going to be, will need to be commented or deleted to allow compiling later, but other lot of functions will need to remain because we are going to reuse a lot of code from before. For now, I'm just gonna comment them all and wait until this is needed. Right, I'm going to comment this one too. And now I just use the bin methods function, but it is not still declared. So for this, I'm going to cut this. I am going to paste it in here just to make sure it is defined. So we have access to pinned methods, to the notifications, and we have a changed callback that I am not sure what it works. I think this is used in combination with a texture regression editor, which will no longer be used. So we probably can comment it from both sides and then remove all its references from the texture regression editor. That's gonna be a lot of work. So no more comments in the chat. Let's see what else am I missing. Right. Let's start with allowing to select an existing tile set. So that will be implementing the dist function, which should be public and is port node, port C. The edit function. Ah, there it is. That's why I didn't find it. So let's see what it does. We have an update tile list that will should change to update texture list. It's a private function, most probably. And we're going to rename it to update texture list. Update texture list. want to, because we're going to change this to date icon later on. Search it in here and let's bring it up over here. Down here. Alright. So when we edit, tileset add change receptor this. What does this do? Change receptors options. Interesting. I've never seen this before. This is probably new. Well, I'm not changing this yet, but I think that we should also register the change receptor at some point, which should be right here if the previous tileset is valid. Well, whatever. Update texture list. Let's see what does this do. Selected texture. In fact, I am going to rename this. Let's say the current texture, and I am not going to rename the function. I'm going to add a new one because I want to have a get current tile too. So let's add, in fact, let's say get current. Let's copy this one to make sure it's fine. Let's give it the name get current texture. Let's find get current tile. Let's choose copy and paste it, and let's make it to get the current texture instead. We're going to use the texture list instead. Just want the index of the texture. Ah, now I get it. I remember. It's okay. I should get the item metadata. That should work, and this is because I'm going to identify the texture by its read ID. But nothing is happening. This is getting a little awkward. Update texture list. Pepper, set. Not sure if we are going to use the helper at the end. Texture list clear. List int ID, style set, get tile list. And now we're going to have some kind of map with the textures. What was this called? Schmuck? Texture map something like this. We'll probably not clear this one in here. Instead, I will probably clear it in the edit callback because of reasons. I'm going to clear the map too. The reason is because I want to keep the texture on the map and on the list, even if I have not more tile set of the of a given texture at some point where I remove the tile. Right, I forgot the delete tile button over here. Something like this. Yeah, this will work. Here. Something like that. Toolbar in here will probably be better. A second layer. Here that depends on the select. So all of this is gone. This to this, this is on. The remove time should disappear too in here. So only when you are selecting this toolbar is gonna be visible. Maybe a third toolbar should be visible in here, because this one is for. Collision. Solution. Navigation. Heat mask, etc. Still have to think this up, but that's more or less what is going to happen. Because this depends on this, and this depends on this. But we're going to think in that later. So, well, what's we in the update list? Right. We get the list of tiles. And then we have to check if the texture is already on the list. If texture map dot has e dot get, then this is not gonna do anything. If this doesn't have it, then we're going to add it. Texture list, add item, blah blah blah. Tile set. Tile get texture. Now that we have the texture, good. Get import path, get path, get name. Maybe it works. What's this gonna return? Results name. I don't know, let's just try it, maybe it works. Close, close, close. What's wrong with this. Leave it outside. Okay. Close it in here. Text to map. Set. Right, the first argument would be right. I need to get the texture. From the texture, I want to read. This is what I want. I want to use the resource ID to reference the texture in this map. So this is what I want to add to the map, and this is what I want to set as the meta of the list. Texture list set item metadata index, it will be the last one. So texture list dot item count. Get the item count minus one. And the value is the right ID. So I think this is all. Texture selected. Selected texture. I have to, almost forgot to set the reference to the texture in here, which is this one. There we go. Now we can access to the textures in here to update the icons on the list. So we can just go update list icon here. We don't need this. So current index for it should move through the list. We're going to rename this style list for texture list. Okay. Now see a reason to change the metadata. Set item icon, index, get tile texture. We don't need this, we have the texture map. And we equals get item metadata. Can get the texture by using the texture map with our grid. Excellent. Russian. I don't think we have to set it up. Don't think we are going to need to modulate. And don't think we need to change the name, because tiles could change its names, but texture doesn't. In fact, they could, but I'm not sure if that's gonna be needed, at least for now. So let it be. Texture list set let's just keep it a maximum size. Just in case. Oh, forgot the index. This is the front index. All right. Should work. Anything is missing to compile. I mean, there are a lot of functions that just won't work because they are not defined, so I'm going to have to comment them out, and that's gonna be large work to do. I'm just going to close the windows I have over here. I don't think I need this. And to the compile, we have a couple of errors. Not sure, looks like it stopped at some point. No more comments. I think I am just going to stop commenting the work because I'm tired and there are no one commenting, so I think it's a little bit useless to make comments on this. So let it be.